Hey everyone, did you know that SOAR uses playbooks to automatically update cases and automate responses to alerts? It also passes the control back to the analyst for some activities. You're a level 1 analyst. You will respond to a case that executed a playbook. You will complete a task and watch the playbook automatically proceed to the next workflow item. Let's play. In the left pane in the list of cases, click the top case. Notice this case already has a modified green needs review status, which was changed by a playbook as soon as the case was evaluated by SOAR. Also notice there is a T in the case and a task in the middle pane. The analyst task, inform deputy manager, you're going to complete this task. First thing you want to do is you want to write a comment. Once done, select complete. Click the comments tab to show only comments. Click the drop-down arrow next to the comment to show the comment you typed when completing the task. The playbook automatically proceeds through its workflow and assigns this case to Mandy Analyst, indicated by the M icon. Notice the case also has a T icon, meaning there is another task to complete. Any pending tasks should be completed by the person assigned to the case. Go ahead and click the M to see the person assigned to the case. And it's Mandy. The case list can be long and you can see everyone's cases. If you only work on cases that are triaged and assigned to you, you might want to filter the case list. You are an analyst named Mandy Analyst, and you have logged on to SOAR to see the cases that you need to work on. There's a lot of cases in your view. You want to filter the cases so you only see those cases assigned to you. In the left pane window below the cases list, click the arrow in the All Cases button. Now click Cases Assigned to Me to show only your cases. Done. Good stuff. The list of cases shows only those cases assigned to you, Mandy Analyst. A SOAR playbook has automatically moved to the next workflow item and is waiting for Mandy, you, to complete a task in a case. You're going to complete this task to add a scope item. Look in the cases list at the first case. Notice there is a T in the case. This means there is a task awaiting completion. Go ahead and click that case. In the middle pane in the analyst task, click the IP address. You want to add a related scope item for the offending IP address, which is shown as the red globe icon under the scope items. Now click the right arrow to move that IP address to the completed scope items column. Click network address under task output. You have identified an IP address that is related to the offender IP address. Type that in. Now click the plus icon next to the IP address you typed to add this IP address to the related scope item. Click complete to add this related scope item to the scope items at the top of the middle pane. The related scope item will show as an orange globe icon. Click on the orange globe to examine more details about the related scope item you added. Oh, by the way, notice the T is no longer in the case? Good stuff. You will finish working on a case and close the case. Click close in the upper right-hand corner. Now type in a closing comment. Once done, click save. Review the case status in the cases list. Notice the case has a green closed status. You can also review the case status and the case details in the right pane. Notice the green closed status in the case details? Above it is a reopen button if you want to reopen the case. You can click comments to see the comment you entered. And there it is. Good stuff. You finished working on a case and you closed a case. For more information, please check out the ArcSight Education After Hours site. Thanks. Hope you enjoyed it.